If you're looking to learn more about SmartGuard technology, you've come to the right place. Our goal is to help improve your experience with the SmartGuard feature, and the information we're about to share should leave you feeling like a time and range rock star in no time. But first, what exactly is SmartGuard technology? SmartGuard technology is what helps your system automatically adjust and deliver insulin based on your real-time sensor glucose readings. You'll still need to enter carbs when you eat and deliver a food bolus. However, don't fret, bolus boss, the system will also deliver correction boluses as needed to help get your sugar levels to a target sensor glucose value. For example, if your sugar levels are running high, the system will deliver more insulin by increasing your basal insulin delivery, or even delivering an auto-correction. If your sugars are trending low, the system will give you less insulin or even stop insulin delivery to help keep your sugars in range. Now that you understand how the SmartGuard feature works, let's go over the requirements for use as well as some of the reasons SmartGuard feature exits may happen. To get into the SmartGuard feature, you'll need the following. First, a carbohydrate ratio and active insulin time. These settings should come directly from your healthcare team and must be programmed into your pump before activating the SmartGuard feature. Second, you must be wearing the Guardian Sensor 3 or the Guardian 4 sensor. Next, you'll need to confirm you don't have any active temp basal or a bolus being delivered. You can check this on your pump's home screen. Last but not least, the system will need a blood sugar reading to use the SmartGuard feature for the very first time. Before you do this, make sure you've washed your hands. Then check your blood sugar and transfer the reading over to your pump. That's it. You should now be ready to use the SmartGuard feature. You can confirm readiness by pressing the center button on the front of your pump, then selecting status, and then selecting SmartGuard checklist. You'll know you're in the SmartGuard feature when you see a blue shield on the front of your pump with a sensor glucose displayed in the middle. One more thing just before you go. It's rare, but from time to time, a SmartGuard feature exit may occur. Here's a look at why that may be. Life happens. You may miss a bolus, miscount your carbs, or your infusion set cannula may kink and need to be replaced. Any of these can cause your sugar levels to rise and the SmartGuard feature to begin to ramp up insulin delivery. However, once it reaches the maximum delivery of 7 hours, it will request a blood sugar. Keep in mind, if that's not entered within 4 hours, it will lead to a SmartGuard feature exit. The opposite of this can happen too. If the SmartGuard feature has been delivering the minimum amount of insulin for 3 to 6 hours, a requested blood sugar isn't entered within 4 hours of that, guess what? Exit. Insulin delivery that's been manually suspended and not resumed for 4 hours will also lead to a SmartGuard feature exit. And lastly, if the sensor feature is turned off on your pump or the sensor has been disconnected from the transmitter for more than 4 hours, you will experience an exit. If any of these happen and you experience an exit, you'll need to address the condition that caused the exit before you can get back in. If you have any trouble at all, remember to check the SmartGuard checklist screen to see what actually needs to be done. That's it for our look at the SmartGuard feature. Until next time, you time and range rockstar.